how to become a hacker. When you think about the many things that hackers can do, which is the first thing that comes to mind? Hacking computers of banks to steal funds from them? Or hacking into the computers in the White House to breach the security in the most secured space in America? Anyway, whatever it is that you have at the back of your mind, you might want to stall on them while we introduce you to the step-by-step guide to becoming a hacker. A lot of people do not know that there are two kinds of hackers, the white hackers and the black hackers. In any case, a hacker is still a hacker, whether it is done with a white hat on or a black hat. Continue viewing this video as we take you from being a newbie hacker to being a rookie in the hacking field. Let's get to it already. Just in case you do not know, the white hat hackers are the better of the two types of hackers, and the reason is because their job is mainly for the purpose of ensuring that the internet space is a safer place to surf on. On the other hand, the black hat hackers are those sorts of hackers that hack into computers for the purpose of stealing documents, money, and sometimes for the fun of it. When you think about it closely, you would recall the name Anonymous from the Black Lives Matter civil disobedience march in America. Anonymous was busy hacking into different computer devices, unveiling vital information of security agencies. Movies have done a great deal of harm to the minds of viewers, and the reason is because many viewers tend to see hackers from the perspective of being nerdy beings who spend the bulk of their time behind computer devices while they save the world with it. This might not be far-fetched from the truth, but there is more about hackers that movie scenes fail to paint in their numerous scripts. According to Eric Raymond, a renowned hacker and an author, he was of the view that the first major step to becoming a hacker is to try to think like one. Hence, becoming a hacker is not just about sitting behind a computer device and planning the next big move to hack into a network of computers. It is first about the mindset. If you must become a hacker, you must learn to think like a hacker. And no jokes, but being a hacker is not about being nerdy, it is more about being innovative. Eric went on to state some of the key features that define a hacker, and he said the second thing that makes a hacker is being a problem solver. Eric opined that there are many problems in the world, and as a hacker, you must be the sort of person that is curious about solving some of the fatal problems that you would find in the world. This means that in order to become an efficient hacker, you must be the sort of person that is curious about problem solving. Another feature that makes you a great hacker is the fact that you must be the sort of person that loves to give out information, because information is a right that shouldn't be veiled from anyone. This is why it is rare to find a single hacker. Hackers have a network, and they share information in that network because there is a rule in hacking that says when information is known, it should be spread all around to other hackers. And this is why it is rare to find a hacker that knows things that are different from other hackers. Perhaps the most pertinent characteristic that would define you as a competent hacker is the fact that you are able to program. Hacking has the hacker dealing with so many programming languages. In this case, there is no shortcut about it. It is either you understand the programming language, or you do not. The best advice that anyone can give you, just in case you are considering delving into the hacking field, is that you should learn about programming languages that are common in the hacking world. Typical examples being Python and Perl. And the reason for this is because there would be constant materials that are dropped at time intervals that would aid in helping you to hack platforms and websites with that sort of programming language. Also, you would need to have it at the back of your mind that you would need to learn about Linux. In case you do not know, Linux is an operating system that is used by 90.6% of computers in the world. And getting to know about Linux means that you would find enough resource to utilize your hacking skills on. You can easily find open source files of Linux online, and then when you install, you get to make use of your programming skills to select the best choice that suits your taste. A lot of newbie hackers do not know that there is a hacking convention that is held on a yearly basis, and it is called DEF CON. DEF CON is a hacking conference that is held by hackers in Las Vegas. It is a conference that would broaden your mind about the newest features when it comes to hacking in its totality. Also, you might be interested in the fact that there are a lot of top-tier hackers that come to the convention on a yearly basis, and this means that when you join this network of hackers, you are likely to get the best information that would have you upping your game in the hacking field. The way that the most common hacking is done is that the hacker floods the server of a website with so many maps that are hard to decipher by the server. A typical example of common hacks that have been done in the past include DDoS attack that allows the server to go offline because the server is unable to process the numerous maps that are jammed into it. DNS cache poisoning is also a common hacking process that most hackers are familiar with. And the way that it works is that it allows a server to process data in such a way that the server thinks that it is connecting to a website. Instead, it connects to the computer device of the hacker, where control is being delivered to the hacker. If you are wondering what the reason for the Great Firewall Buffer was in China a couple of years back, it is because of the DNS cache poisoning, and it might interest you to know that it is the reason why at some point the use of Facebook and Twitter was banned in China. Also, you might want to know that the use of computers is not what makes a hacker. Rather, it is the susceptibility in social engineering that makes hacking easier for hackers. In the year 2003, a survey was done on the reason why hacking was easier with corporate organizations, and it was deduced that it was because employees gave computer engineers access to their passwords and login details. Do you feel better informed about all that it takes to become a hacker now? What are some of those things that you think would most likely make a great hacker? What do you think about this content? Was it enlightening, or were there expectations that we didn't cover? Let's have your thoughts in the comments segment of this video. Until much later, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for some more mind-melting content just like this one.